This is the fourth video of the ratio chapter. In this video, I will discuss these sums. Okay. First of all, I will show how to turn the ratio into simplest form, right? This is the most common type of the sum which is asked in the ratio chapter. So first example here I am showing. Suppose you have to turn a ratio 72:108 into its simplest form. Okay, so this is the first method, 72:108. I divided the numerator and denominator by taking a number 2, okay, as a common factor. Next, I can again take 2 or 3 because the divisibility rule is passing for both the numbers 2 and 3, because 3 plus 6 9 5 plus 4 9. Taking bigger number for cancellation is always convenient, that reduces the steps, right? So here I am taking 9 for cancellation. Okay, so here we get 4 and 6, right? At last we can divide 4 and 6 with the 2. I have taken here 2. So the simplest form of this ratio is 2:3. This is the number one method. Okay. The second method here I am showing, 72:108. You can find out the HCF of these two numbers, and just by cancelling with the help of the HCF, you can find the simplest form in one step. How? First of all, I am finding the HCF. So the last divisor is 36, therefore 36 is the HCF of these two number. Therefore, we can reduce this ratio 72:108 by taking 36, the HCF of the two term of the ratio. We can reduce in one step. Okay. Therefore, 2:3 is the simplest form that is obtained in one step. The second one I want to show is a fraction. So 1:6:1:2, right? What I will do here, 1:6:2 means divide 1:2. Okay, that is 1:6 turn divide into multiplication and just invert the second fraction like this. So 2:1:2, 2:3:6. I will cancel up and down and multiply top side and bottom side. So 1:1:1 and 3:1:3. So the simplest form is 1:3. Right? The third example I am showing here. Suppose there is a sum 15 cm to 4 m. Right, so here it is more important that in a ratio, I have pointed out in the first video that the unit of the both quantity must be same, right? So here is the quantity's length, but this is in centimeter, this is in meter. So it is more convenient to turn the larger unit into a smaller unit, right? So I can write it like this, 15 cm is to 4 m. You write like this, okay? Equal to 15 cm is to 400 cm. Just what I did, 4 m equal to 4 into 100 cm. Okay. Now I will write this into fractional form, 15 cm by 400 cm. Centimeter, centimeter get cancelled, and it comes 15 by 400. Right, now I will take a number and to simplify the ratio into its simplest form. I am taking 5. 5 3 5 area 40 0, 3 by 80. It is the simplest form, 3 by 80. Therefore the ratio is 3:80, and this is the simplest form. That means no more cancellation is possible after this number, right? So this sum is based on dividing a number in a given ratio. So here I am reading the sum. Population of a village is 32,400. The ratio of literate to illiterate person in the village is 11:7. Find the actual number of the literate person and illiterate person. Alright, so I have to find the literate person and illiterate person. The term in the ratio for the literate person is 11 and that for the illiterate person is 7. So I will write the sum of the ratio, 11 plus 7, that is equal to 18. Now the number of literate person equal to sum of the ratio into total population of that village, this one. Okay, if I cancel by 18, so I will get this, and after multiplying we'll get 19,800 person are literate person, and illiterate person can be found by the same division process or by subtracting the literate person from the total population. So here I am showing the same method. Ratio of the illiterate person divided by sum of the ratio into total population, 32,400. So we will get here 1800, that is 12,600 are illiterate people in the village. So this sum has the method of dividing any number in a given ratio. Okay. So this is the third sum. I am reading the sum. If A, B and C are three numbers such that A is to B equal to 4:9 and B is to C equal to 27:35, find A is to C. Right? So first of all, we will write the given data. So given here, A is to B equal to 4:9 and B is to C equal to 27:35. Okay, so we have to calculate A is to C, right? We can notice here that if I write the ratio in this form, A is to B and second ratio is B is to C. Okay, so here we have to apply our brain that if we multiply both the ratio, then B and B will get cancelled and there will be left only AC, that is the A by C, which means A is to C, right? So we will write here, after multiplying both the ratio, A by B, we will write in fractional form, B by C equal to 4 by 9 into 27 by 35. As first I wrote A by B, therefore I write the first ratio 4 by 9. Now this B and this B gets cancelled, it become A is to C, and here we will cancel whatever possible here. 9 3 27, and further no more cancellation is possible here. 4, 3 are 12 and by 35. Okay, so A is to C is 12 is to 35, and this is your answer, right? For solving this sum, first I will find the multiplying ratio. Okay, here the final quantity and original quantity relates to 1650 respectively. That means the original quantity is 650, that was increased to 1000, so 1000 is the final quantity. We will write therefore we can write original quantity is to final quantity. First I am writing here, equal to 20 is to 13. I am reversing the order of the ratio. I am writing original quantity first, is to 20. That means original quantity to the final quantity is 13 is to 20. That means if any original quantity is increased to final value, therefore the ratio in which it should be increased will be 13 is to 20. So you will write therefore rupees 650 is to be increased in 13 is to 20 ratio. Okay, to obtain 1000. So this is your answer, right? So I have discussed few questions of ratio. If you have any critical problems of the ratio, then you can ask here in the comment box.